We graduated 16 out of that academy, one of the largest classes ever that we've had. But it takes time to train them, to get them on them. From the time we hire them, put them through the academy to where they're a solo working body, it takes almost a year and a half to 2 years. So it's a long process, but we're finally in a good position to where we're going to see the fruits of our labor by the end of this year. Another thing we've done is programming in the jail. We have a great programs director at the Monterey County Jail. We've teamed up with the Salinas Union High School District. I believe we did that back in 2015 or 2016 to try and get inmates who haven't received their GED to try and either complete it while they're in jail, or if they're released during the process, we try to team them up with a counselor to where they get their GED so we can give them a sense of accomplishment and hopefully go out and find a job. We've teamed with Hartnell College. We've teamed with a company called the Geo Group that provides programming in the jail, anger management, parenting classes. We've held 4 job fairs over the last 3 years through the Geo Group, trying to connect inmates with potential employers throughout Monterey County. Just recently, we started a drone program. They helped us purchase 5 drones, which we've deployed throughout the county. We've certified several deputies on the operation of those drones, and we just recently started that drone program, which in the long run is going to be very beneficial to us, not only in search and rescue, but when we have suspects that flee in the neighborhoods, and instead of sending dogs out that are sometimes could be a liability, we can send up a drone and take a picture of the area and get an aerial view of the area. Instead of sending our officers into a potentially dangerous situation, we can use those drones to our advantage. So when I put the agent in the jail, my idea was, number one, public safety in Monterey County, because I'm responsible for the public safety of not only documented citizens, but undocumented citizens. So I made the choice to put the ICE agent in the jail to hand over criminals, because we can't, when ICE gives us a detainer, we can't simply hold somebody based on an ICE detainer. So my idea was, let's have them in the jail to where they can take custody of criminals and we keep them out of the community. It was a safe exchange. It was an exchange that happened at the jail. There wasn't a foot chase, there wasn't a car chase. It didn't happen in front of family. It didn't drive ICE out into the community to where if they went and picked up these criminals in the community, they could possibly pick up collateral deportees just based simply on immigration status. So we knew when they were in the jail, they were only picking up people who violated state law. They violated the penal code. When SB 54 passed, and we knew that was going to become law on January 1st, I brought in, I contacted an immigration attorney, Blanca Zarazuo. It was one of the first ones I contacted, and also Supervisor Alejo's office. I met regularly with a group called COPA, Immigration Coalition, and I invited everybody to come and have a voice on what our policy was going to be once SB 54 took effect. And backing up, when I had the ICE agent in the jail, I tried to connect with the migrant community to get them the message that, at that time, if you did, ICE agents weren't going out in the field.
Under your watch, Sheriff, we've had Pizzagate, we've had your opponent investigated for a spike strip. We have an investigation that just recently wrapped up regarding deputy or someone improperly filling out these search warrants. Some might look at that and say, okay, these things happen under your watch. Maybe you don't have a control of the office, of your staff. Your thoughts on that?
I can't comment specifically to any of those that you just mentioned. The only thing I will say is I hope people will look at me and my staff, my administration over the last 4 years, and the public demands transparency, especially in law enforcement today, and we're holding people accountable. The bottom line is we're going to hold people accountable And, you know, I want deputy sheriffs out there that the public can trust, and I will hold them accountable. When I go out and speak in public, I hear great things about our deputies, what a great job they're doing. It's hard for me to believe that morale is low with a majority of the employees at the sheriff's office. I will tell you, it's not low. I just came back from a state conference of sheriffs, and every sheriff's office has some form of low morale. But what I see, and especially just being a deputy just recently, is you have a very small group whose morale is low. They don't like coming to work. There's another small group that are tickled to death to come to work, and they support the upper administration. But then you have a larger group in the middle who just don't get involved. They come to work, they do their job, and they take pride in their work, and then they go home to their families. And it's funny listening to other sheriffs, because we're not different.
You were the young kid on the block.
Thanks for that.
Inexperienced, was what they were saying. Now you've got 4 years behind you. Has a lot changed in the last 4 years?
A lot has changed in the last 4 years. You know, I've not only has a lot changed, you know, I've learned a lot in this job. Going from deputy to sheriff, for anybody, that's a learning experience. And, you know, we've gone through a lot. A lot has changed. I inherited a jail lawsuit. You know, with AB 109, prison realignment, with Prop 47, we've seen a lot of legislative changes. So it changes public safety in Monterey County. So, you know, every year from year one, we've gotten better and better. And I look forward to 4 more years to where we can continue getting better each year.